请拜大家。
我们可以开始。暂停。
好，我们稍等一下啊，顾问好像在忙。
我不忙。我们可以开始。
Recording in progress。
好的，顾问，我们可以开始了。
Om Jnanatmarandasya Gyananjana Shalakaya Chaksur Militanyena Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha Nama Om Vishnu Padaya Krishna Pristaya Bhutale Srimati Bhaktivedanta Swaminiti Namane Namaste Saraswati Devi Gauravani Pracharine Nirvisesha Shunyavadi Paschacha De Satarine Vanchakaupatarubhyascha Kripa Sindhubhai Vacha Patitanam Pavanebhyo Vaishnavibhyo Namo Namaha Jai Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadha Srivasadi Gaur Bhaktavinda Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. So we're going through Canto 6, and we're hearing about the appearance of the demon Vritasura, as described in Chapter 9 of the 6th Canto.
我们学习的是《圣典波迦瓦坛》第六篇的第九章。这一章我们要了解恶魔维特苏拉的显现。
So it happened that the demigods, headed by Indra, committed an offense against their guru, Brihaspati. So Brihaspati left them.
以 Indra 为首的半神人，他们冒犯了他们灵性导师 Brihaspati， 然后 Brihaspati 离开了他们。
When they didn't have the guru, they got defeated by the demons.
当他们没有自己的灵性导师之后，他们就被恶魔所击败了。
So Indra went to Lord Brahma and he asked Lord Brahma what to do. And so they suggested to him that you could take another guru. You can get Vishwarup to be your guru.
于是他们就去寻找 Brahma 的建议，主 Brahma 建议他们，你们现在可以去找另外一个灵性导师 Vishwarupa 作为你们的灵性导师。
The problem was Vishwarupa was loyal to the demons as well as to the demigods.
这 Vishwarupa 的问题是他对恶魔和对半神人都是有一点关系的。
Mother was from the side of the demons, and father was from the side of the demigods.
Vishwarupa 的母亲是来自于恶魔那一方，他的父亲是来自于半神这一方。
So he gave the demigods the Narayana Kavacha mantra to protect them, so they could defeat the demons.
Vishwarupa 给了半神人一个 Narayana Kavacha 这个盾，给了半神人。这样半神人就足以击败恶魔。
But when Vishwarupa was offering oblations, he would offer oblations for the demigods, and then he would offer oblations for the demons.
当 Vishwarupa 供奉祭品的时候，他供奉了一部分给半神人，同时他还给这个恶魔供奉了。
And so when Indra found out what he was doing, Indra killed him.
当 Indra 发现了 Vishwarupa 所做的这一切之后， Indra 就杀了 Vishwarupa。
So that was an offensive thing to do because Vishwarupa was a Brahmana.
这其实也是一个冒犯，因为 Vishwarupa 他是一个婆罗门。
And his father was a powerful Brahmana. His father did a Vedic sacrifice to get a son who would kill Indra.
Vishwarupa 的父亲也是一位很有力量的婆罗门，他想通过一个祭祀来获得一个 儿子来杀掉鹰爪。
But when the father was doing the sacrifice, he made a mistake in the mantra.
但是当他的父亲在做伟达祭祀的时候，他发错了一个伟达曼陀罗的音。
And he didn't get a son who would kill Indra, but he got a son who was the enemy of Indra.
他并没有得到一个能杀死 Indra 的儿子，但是他得到了一个 Indra 的敌人。
So, the child who was born from the sacrifice to kill Indra, he was a powerful, he was huge, a gigantic demon. His name was Vrita. Vrita means someone who is spread everywhere.
这个祭祀产生了一个非常巨大的恶魔。Vrita 的意思是能够扩散到很多地方的。
So when the demigods came to fight the demons, this big demon came in front of the demigods, and demigods were terrified, and they all ran away.
当这些半神人想要去跟这个恶魔作战的时候，他发现这个恶魔实在是太恐惧了，于是都逃散了。
They would fire weapons at the demon would just swallow them up.
他们把武器都扔向了恶魔，但是恶魔全都把他们弄掉了，吞掉了。
So then the demigods went to the Supreme Personality of Godhead, Narayan, to ask him for help.
半神人就到主 Narayan 的那里去寻求帮助。
And we're hearing the prayers they offered to Lord Narayan.
我们现在聆听到的是半神人向主 Narayan 的供奉的祷文。
So they prayed to Lord Narayan that we know that you have no material body.
半神人对主 Narayan 说，我们知道您根本就没有物质的躯体。
So you don't need any cooperation from us.
您不需要我们的合作。
You are the cause of the cosmic manifestation.
您是宇宙展示的根源。
And you supply all the material ingredients.
您支持着物质的一切，物质元素的一切。
You create, you maintain, and you annihilate the whole material world.
您创造维系和毁灭整个宇宙展示。
You do everything by yourself.
所有的这一切您都自己在做。
So although it appears like you're engaged in material activities, we know you are transcendental.
因此即便好像你在从事这些物质的活动，但实际上您是超然的。
So all of your activities are very difficult to understand.
您所有的这些活动都极难以理解。
Brahma Samhita describes how the Supreme Lord Krishna resides in Goloka Vrindavan.
在 Brahma Samhita 描述了主他是如何居住在 Goloka Vrindavan 的。
But at the same time, he's everywhere in everything.
但与此同时，他又处在每一个地方，每一件事物之中。
And it's also said that Krishna never goes even a step away from Vrindavan.
还说到主 Krishna 永远不会离开 Vrindavan 甚至一步。
So Krishna's in Goloka Vrindavan, but at the same time, he's everywhere.
主 Krishna 在居住在 Goloka Vrindavan, 同时他又无所不在。
So it's very difficult for ordinary people to understand.
因此这对每一个普通人来说是很难以理解的。
But devotees can understand.
但是奉献者可以理解。
We can understand how Krishna can be in his abode and at the same time he's everywhere.
奉献者可以理解他主 Krishna 是如何又居住在自己的居所，同时又无所不在的。
And the demigods, they're like different limbs of the body of the Supreme Lord.
半神人们被理解为是至尊主的 各个不同的躯体的肢体，就是躯体的各个不同的肢体部分。
Actually, the Supreme Lord doesn't have a material body.
至尊主没有物质的躯体。
He doesn't need anybody's help.
他不需要任何人的帮助。
He's spread everywhere.
他存在于每一处。
But he's not present everywhere in his spiritual form.
但是他不是说以灵性的形体存在于每一个地方。
Now the Mayavadis, they have a different philosophy.
那些 Mayavadi 虚无主义者，他们有他们自己的哲学。
Yeah, they say that the Supreme Lord, that he's everywhere.But he does not need to have a transcendental form.
Mayavadi 他们说，至尊主他变存万有，无需要他们不需要至尊主不需要一个超人的躯体。
Because they say because his form is everywhere, so he actually has no form.
因为他遍布各处，所以他没有形体。
So this is not true.
这不是真实的。
The Lord keeps his, he keeps a transcendental form.
主保持着他的超然形体。
And at the same time, he's everywhere.
同时他又无所不在。
In every part of the material creation.
在创造的每一个角落。
So the demigods say,they have some inquiries to put to the Lord.
半世人对主有一些询问。
They say that the conditioned souls are subject to the material law.
受条件限制的灵魂受束缚于被束缚于这个物质的法律。
So they get the result of all their actions.
他们由他们的活动得到他们的结果。
So the demigods want to know.They want to know, does the Supreme Lord, is he like an ordinary human being who's within the material world, in the body produced by the material modes?
他们就问道，至尊主，您是否如普通人般，在这个物质世界有一个物质躯体，而这个物质躯体又是由物质属性所产生存在的？
And this is this the Supreme Lord. Does do you have to suffer or enjoy the good or bad results of your actions?
您是否也在享受着活动的善和恶的结果呢？
Or are you just present here just to witness everything?
或者说，您显现在这儿只是监视着这一切。
Are you without any material desires?
您是否有任何的物质欲望呢？
We cannot understand what is your actual position.
我们是确切的能知道您的真实地位。
So this was the demigod's inquiry.
Sorry, Gurudev. The last sentence, actually, the demigod, whether they know the position of the Lord,
said, we cannot understand your position.
Okay, sorry. 半神最后说是，我们肯定无法明白您真实的地位，我们无法明白。
So they have to ask the Lord himself, what is your position?
所以他们就问至尊主，您的真实地位是怎样。
So in the Bhagavad Gita, Krishna says why he comes to the material world.
在《博迦梵歌》中，主 Krishna 告诉了他为什么要显现于这个物质世界。
He comes to give pleasure to the devotees and to kill the demons.
他来到这里给予奉献者快乐以及除掉恶魔。
So whether he's killing the demons or giving pleasure to the devotees, it's actually the same thing for Krishna.
无论是他给奉献者带来快乐还是杀掉恶魔，这二者实际上对于主 Krishna 来说是同样的一件事情。
When he punishes the demons, he actually gives mercy to them.
当主惩罚恶魔的时候，实际上是主给予他们仁慈。
And when he pleases, when he gives mercy to the devotees, he's actually delivering them.
当主给予奉献者仁慈的时候，主是在拯救奉献者。
So both the demons and the devotees, they get the blessings of Krishna.
不论是奉献者还是恶魔，都得到了主的仁慈和祝福。
Krishna is very kind to the conditioned souls.
主 Krishna 对受条件限制的灵魂非常的仁慈。
When they need to get relief, if a conditioned soul gives relief to somebody, that's his pious activity.
当受条件限制的灵魂去帮助他人救赎时，就是救赎他人的时候，这样的活动是很虔诚的。
But when he gives trouble to others, that's his impious.
当一个人给予他人制造麻烦的时候，他的活动是不虔诚的。
But Krishna is not pious or impious.
但是主 Krishna 既不虔诚也不虔诚。
He is always in his spiritual bliss.
他总是在他的灵性存在之中。
And he gives mercy equally to the sinful and to the devotees.
他仁慈，他同等的给予他的仁慈给这些奉献者以及那些罪恶的人。
Krishna is never contaminated by any reactions from any sinful activities.
主 Krishna 从不会被任何污染的罪恶的活动所污染。
When Krishna came to this earth, he killed many, many non-devotees, many demons.
当主 Krishna 显现在这个地球时，他杀了很多的恶魔。
But the people who were killed by Krishna, they all got to go to the spiritual, they got their spiritual bodies.
当这些恶魔如果能够被主 Krishna 所杀死的话，他们能够得到明心的躯体。
So people who don't know Krishna's position, they say, oh, Krishna is not kind. He's not kind to people. He's not merciful.
那些不了解主 Krishna 的人，他们说主 Krishna 并不仁慈。
But actually, Krishna himself says in the Bhagavad Gita, he said, I'm equal to everyone.
但事实上，主 Krishna 在《薄伽梵歌》中说，我平等的对所有的人。
Nobody is my enemy, nobody is my friend.
没有人是我的敌人，也没有人是我的朋友。
If somebody becomes my devotee and surrenders to me, then I will give him special attention.
假如谁成为我的奉献者，臣服于我，我会给予他特殊的关照。
So the demigods continue to offer prayers to Lord Narayan.
半世人继续向主那儿样的供奉祷文。
And they say, oh, Supreme Lord, they say, all the contradictions can be reconciled in you.
至尊人格首师啊，一切的矛盾都能在您之中达到协调一致。
They say, you're the reservoir of unlimited spiritual qualities.
您是无限灵性品质的储藏所。
You're the supreme controller.
您是至尊的控制者。
And your glories are unlimited and inconceivable.
您的荣耀是 无限制的，而且是不可思议的。
So some people who believe in God or think about religion, people who are religious, they argue about what's right and what's wrong.
现在的一些神学家们，他们总是争论到底哪些是对的，哪些是错的。
But they don't really know what is right and what's wrong.
但是实际上他们并不知道什么是正确，什么是错误。
So their arguments are always false.
他们的争论总是存在的错误。
And their judgments are not accurate.
他们的判断也没有结果。
They have no evidence to establish what is actually the truth.
他们对于绝对真理没有证据。
Their minds are always agitated by the scriptures.
他们的心意总是被各种各样的经典所打扰。
In the scriptures, there's many different conclusions.
而这些经典总是有很多不同的结论。
So they cannot understand what the truth actually is.
因此他们无法理解到底什么是真理。
So they're eager to arrive at the right, they want to come to the right conclusion, but their theories are not capable of coming to the truth.
他们是非常渴望想到达绝对真理，但是他们的理论不能到达绝对真理。
The Supreme Lord is one without a second.
至尊主是举世无双的那一位。
So, although there are contradictions, it's like happiness and distress. They're not actually contradictory.
有快乐和痛苦这样的一些矛盾，但是实际上在主那里是没有这样的矛盾的。
But your potency is so great.It can do anything, and it can undo anything.
因为您的能力是如此的伟大，所以您可以做，也可以不做。
There's nothing impossible for you.
对于您来说，没有什么是不可能的。
There's no duality in your position.
在您的位置上是没有双重、二重性的。
You can do everything by your energy.
您可以通过您的能量做一切的事情。
So the Supreme Lord is self-sufficient.
至尊主是自我满足的。
He's full of transcendental bliss.
他是永远充盈着超然的喜乐。
And he gets bliss in two ways.
他通过两种方式得到这种喜乐。
When he appears happy and when he appears distressed, both ways he's happy.
无论他是显现为快乐还是显现为痛苦，实际上都是处于极乐。
So contradictions are impossible in him.
因此，矛盾在他身上是不可能存在的。
Because everything has come from him.
因为一切都流源于他。
So he is the reservoir of all knowledge.
他是所有的知识的来源。
All the potency, all the strength, opulence, influence, it all comes from Krishna.
所有的能力、力量、富裕和影响力，所有都来自于至尊主，都来自于他。
There's no limit to his power.
他的能力、他的力量是无边际的。
There's nothing abominable from the material world that can exist in him.
没有什么令人不快的事情可以在他身上存在。
He's always transcendental and spiritual.
他永远是超然的，而且是灵性的。
So, if we think about material happiness and material distress, this doesn't apply to Krishna.
我们所想的这种物质的快乐和痛苦并不适用于他。
But we shouldn't be surprised when we find contradictions in Krishna.
但是我们也惊奇地发现，在至尊主身上存在矛盾。
There are contradictions. Oh, there are no contradictions.
就是我们不应该惊奇地发现，在至尊主身上存在矛盾。事实上。
That's why, because Krishna is the Supreme, there can't be any contradiction in him.
因为主 Krishna 是至尊的，因此在他身上没有矛盾。
So he's always powerful above everyone.
他永远是全能的，超越于一切人。
And he's happy to protest.The devotees. He's happy to protect the devotees by killing the demons.
他非常乐于杀死这些恶魔来保护奉献者。
Krishna enjoys both the killing and the protecting.
它满足于杀死，也满足于保护。
So freedom from duality appears not only to Krishna but also to his devotees.
免于二重性的这种自由，既适用于至尊主，也适用于至尊主的奉献者。
Just like the gopis, they enjoy pleasure in the company of Krishna and Vrindavan.
就像主 Krishna 的在 Vrindavan 的这些 gopi 木流姑娘们，他的这些同伴们。
But Krishna and the gopis feel the same, they feel the same bliss in separation.
不论是主还有他的奉献者，他们都享受着在分离中的极乐之情。
When Krishna and Balaram leave Vrindavan to go to Mathura, then the gopis experience also ecstasy in separation.
当主 Krishna 和 Balaram 离开 Vrindavan 去到 Mathura 的时候，这些木流姑娘们，她们也在分离中感受着极乐。
So we should understand there is no material pain or pleasure for Krishna or for his pure devotees.
对于主 Krishna 以及他的纯粹奉献者来说，并不存在物质的痛苦和快乐的问题。
Sometimes they're said to be distressed, sometimes happy.
他们表面上有时候是痛苦，有些时候是快乐。
But actually, they're transcendental.
但事实上，这些都是超然的。
They're blissful both ways.
他们以一种极乐的方式存在于两个方面。
But non-devotees, they cannot understand this.
但是对于非奉献者，他们无法理解这一点。
So Krishna says in the Bhagavad Gita.That he can only be understood by devotion.
所以主 Krishna 在薄伽梵歌中说，只有通过奉献服务才能够了解他。
Otherwise, for people who are not devotees, they can never understand Krishna.
不然的话，对于非奉献者，他们无法理解主 Krishna.
So Krishna's name, his form.His pastimes, paraphernalia, are all inconceivable to non-devotees.
所以主 Krishna 的他的形体、名字、逍遥时光、随身用品，对于非奉献者来说都是不可思议的。
So we should not try to understand these things just by our mind.
我们不应该只是用我们的心意去理解这些事情。
That will not help us to understand.The absolute truth.
这不会帮助我们去理解这种高的绝对真理。
So then the demigods give an example.
半世人们又举了一个例子。
They say just like a rope causes fear for a bewildered person, they think it's a snake.
就像一个绳子对于一个被迷惑了的人来说是很恐惧的，他会认为这个绳子就是一条蛇。
But the person with the proper intelligence, he knows it's not a snake, it's just a rope.
但是对于一个有智慧的人来说，他知道这不是一条蛇，而只是一条绳子。
So in the same way, Krishna is the super soul in everyone's heart.
同样的，至尊主 Krishna 他在每一个人的心中。
So in somebody's heart, he may inspire fear. In somebody else's heart, there's no fear.
有的人的内心他有恐惧，有的人的内心他是无惧的。
Will depend on their particular state of mind, their intelligence.
这些都依据他们特定的智慧和心意决定。
But in Krishna, there's no duality.
但是在主 Krishna 的身上是没有二重性。
In the Bhagavad Gita, Krishna says, as you surrender to me, I reward you accordingly.
主 Krishna 在薄伽梵歌中说，根据一个人臣服我的程度，我给予相应的回报。
Krishna is the reservoir of everything, including all knowledge.
主 Krishna 包括一切的知识，它是一切的根源。
And all truth and all contradictions, they also come from Krishna.
一切的真理和一切的矛盾都来自于主 Krishna.
Just like in the example, the rope is one truth, but some people think it's a snake.
就像前面举的这个例子，一条绳子，它这个真理，但是有一些人，他却以为这个绳子是一条蛇。
So devotees who know Krishna, they don't see any contradictions in him.
但是一个奉献者，他知道主 Krishna 身上他是没有任何矛盾之处的。
But the non-devotees, they think of Krishna, they think Krishna is like a snake, and they think they fear him.
但是非奉献者，他认为主 Krishna 就是一条蛇，而且他还害怕这个主 Krishna。
Just like when Lord Nrisingadeva appeared, Prahlad Maharaj saw Lord Nrisingadeva as the supreme shelter.
当主尼辛哈德瓦显现的时候 ，Prahlad Maharaj 他认为主尼辛哈德瓦是至尊的庇护所。
But Prahlad's father Hiranyakashipu, when he saw Lord Nrisingadeva, he thought this is death personified.
但是普拉德马哈拉吉的父亲和人家卡西普看到主尼辛哈德瓦的时候，他认为他是死亡的化身。
So fear comes because we think in terms of duality.
恐惧来自于我们对二重性的、二元性的专注，二重性的专注。
So in duality, there can be fear and there can be bliss.
当一个人在二重性中，有可能是快乐，有可能就是痛苦。
So, from the Supreme Lord, there comes bliss to the devotees, and for the non-devotees, there's fear.
对于奉献者来说，至尊主是喜乐的根源；对于非奉献者来说，至尊主同样也是恐惧的根源。
But God is one, but people understand differently.
神只是一个，神是一个，但是不同的人有不同的角度去理解绝对真理。
Unintelligent people see contradictions in him.
没有智性的人在主的身上看到的是矛盾。
But for the devotees, there's no contradiction.
但是对清醒的奉献者来说，没有矛盾。
So if we think carefully, we will see that the Supreme Lord, although he appears in different ways,He's actually the same everywhere.
如果一个人深思熟虑，会思考得很清楚的话，他会知道那位至尊主，他虽然以不同的方式显现，但是实际上是同一位主。
The material energy is the cause of the material world.
物质能量是物质展示的原因。
But the material energy comes from Krishna.
但是物质能量却来自于主 Krishna.
So Krishna is the cause of all causes.
所以主 Krishna 是一切原因的原因，一切之根源。
And from Krishna comes intelligence and the senses.
由主 Krishna 那里产生的智性和感官。
So we see him everywhere as a super soul.
我们看一切。他是主，我们在超灵之中看到他。
Yeah, he's the super soul of everything.
他是一切的超灵。
And without him, everything would be dead.
没有他的话，所有的都是死的。
So the demigods say that you're the super soul, the supreme controller, you are the only one remaining.
所以半世人说，您是那位超灵、至高无上的控制者，您是唯一存在的那位。
So we have to understand Krishna's position, how he's the active principle of everything.
所以我们要了解至尊主，他是万事万物活动的原则。
Everything depends on him.
一切都依靠于他。
So Krishna enters into every universe and every atom.
主 Krishna 进入到每一个宇宙和每一个原子之中。
And displays, through his energy, he displays the material creation.
通过他的能量，他展示创造了一切。
So Krishna is all pervading through all the different universes.
主 Krishna 是通过每一个宇宙，遍存万有，遍存万有于每一个宇宙之中。
In the Bhagavad Gita, Krishna says, he said that, I am the knower in all bodies.
主 Krishna 在薄伽梵歌中说，我是每一个躯体的知悉者。
Yeah, because he's the super soul, so he knows everything about all the bodies.
因为他是超灵，所以他知道每一个躯体。
And he's even within every atom.
他甚至在每一个原子之中。
So some people, they realize the Lord as the form of the Supreme in everything through His energy.
有一些人能够觉悟到至尊主是以他的能量处在每一切事物之中。
So some people, they simply know God through the three modes.
有一些人只是通过物质自然三种属性理解着至尊主。
And we understand Krishna's presence according to the modes of nature.
我们知道至尊主也通过他的物质自然三属性存在于物质自然之中。
So the demigods pray to Lord Narayan. They call him, they say, Oh, killer of the Madhu demon.
半世人跟至尊主说道：“哦，马杜摩的徒者。
Anybody who tastes a drop of the nectar from the ocean of your glories, then they're in bliss.
任何一位能够品尝到来自于您荣耀之阳，能够品尝到您荣耀之阳那滴甘露的人，这个人将会获得持续不断的超然喜乐。”
So these devotees, they forget about the reflection of material happiness. They forget about material happiness.
而这样的奉献者，他会忘记物质的这些快乐的反应。
They know that material happiness is very small and insignificant.
他们知道这个物质的快乐是非常的微小而微不足道的。
So they're free from all desires.So these devotees are actually the real friend of everyone because they have no material desire.
因为这样的奉献者，他免于所有的物质欲望，因此他是所有众生的朋友。
Yeah, they give their minds to service to Lord Krishna.
他们把他们的内心献给主 Krishna.
And they're expert in enjoying and getting the real goal of life.
他们非常擅长于取得人生的真正目标。
So the demigods say, you are actually the soul and you're the dear friend of all the devotees.
半世人说，您是这种奉献者的灵魂和亲密的奉献者，亲密的朋友。
And these devotees, they never need to come back to the material world.
而这样的奉献者也永不需要重返这个物质世界。
They will never give up.Devotional service.
他们永远不会放弃对于您的奉献服务。
But people who are non-devotees, they speculate and they have very small knowledge. They cannot understand the nature of Krishna.
但是那些非奉献者，因为他们的知识贫乏，喜欢推敲，他们却无法能够理解主 Krishna.
But a devotee, if he just once tastes.The nectar of devotional service, they will never give up.
而如果一个奉献者只要哪怕一次品尝过至尊主的这个甘露，他就永远不会放弃。
And devotee knows that just by giving service to Krishna, he's serving everyone.
奉献者知道，只要是服务主 Krishna, 他便服务了所有的人。
So the devotees are the real friends to everyone.
因此奉献者是每一个人的真正的朋友。
Only the pure devotees can preach about the glories of Krishna for the benefit of the conditioned souls.
只有纯粹奉献者为了所有受条件限制灵魂的利益，会传播主的荣耀。
So the demigods pray to the Lord. They say, "You are the personification of the three worlds."
暗示人继续说，您是三个世界的人格化身。
You are the father of the three worlds.
您是三个世界的父亲。
And you are the strength of the three worlds.
您是三个世界的力量。
And you come in the form of Lord.
Vamanadeva.
And you have a three-eyed form as Lord Nrisimhadev.
And
you are the most beautiful person in the three worlds.
So
everyone, including the human beings and even the demons, and even the Daitya demons and the Danavas,They're all just an expansion of your energy.
所有的人，包括人类，包括呆提亚、恶魔和丹纳瓦，都只是您的能量的扩展。
And so, the demigods pray that to the Lord that you always appear in your form and the various incarnations, just to punish the demons.
办事人跟主说：“您恒常的以您各种化身显现，惩罚那些恶魔。”
When he sees the demon becoming powerful, then the Lord will come and punish him.
当您看到恶魔强大无比的时候，您显现，您化身前来惩罚这些恶魔。
Just like you appeared as Lord Vamanadeva and Lord Rama and Lord Krishna.
就像您显现为主 Vamanadeva。主 Rama 和主 Krishna,
and sometimes you come as an animal like Lord Varaha.
您有时候还显现为一头动物，就像主 Varaha.
And sometimes you're mixed incarnation like Lord Nrisimhadev.
您有时还是一个混合，显现为混合的化身，就像主 Nrisimhadev.
Or Lord Hayagriva.
或者主 Hayagriva.
Or sometimes you're an aquatic like Lord Matsya or Lord Kurma.
有时候您显现为水族的动物，比如说主 Matsya 和主 Kurma。
So in these different forms, you will punish the demons and the Danavas.
您化身为各种各类的形体来惩罚这些恶魔和 Danava。
So the demigods pray to the Lord that we pray that today you will also come in another incarnation.And then you can kill this great demon, Vritasura.
我们今天也祈求您显现为另外一个化身。如果您愿意的话，帮助我们杀死这个 Vritasura 的恶魔。
So we should understand there are two kinds of devotees. Some devotees have material desires and some have no material desires.
有两类的奉献者，有一些奉献者是存有物质欲望的，有一些奉献者没有物质欲望。
So the devotees in the upper planetary system, like the demigods, they have material desires.
在高等星系的这些奉献者，办事人，他们是有物质欲望的。
They still want to enjoy material opulence.
他们仍然还想享受他们的物质富裕。
So that these devotees with material desires, they get promoted to the higher planetary system.
这些有物质欲望的奉献者，他们被提升到高等的星系。
But in their heart, they still desire to lord over the material nature.
在他们的内心之中，他们仍然渴望主宰物质自然。
So sometimes these devotees, they get disturbed by the demons.
有些时候这样的一些奉献者他们被恶魔所打扰。
But the Lord is so kind that he will save them by killing the demons.
但是主非常的仁慈，主通过各种化身来拯救他们。
Just like Lord Vamanadeva appeared and he covered the whole universe with two steps.
就像主巴曼的 Dave 他显现以三步之遥覆盖了整个宇宙。
And then he had no place for his third step.
第三步就根本没有他的立足的地方。
So he asked Bali Maharaj where he could take his third step, and Bali Maharaj allowed him to take that third step on his head.
主巴曼的 Deva 就问巴利马哈拉吉，我现在两步就把整个宇宙都覆盖了，那我的第三步应该放在什么地方呢？巴利马哈拉吉就说，那你就把第三步就放在我的头上。
So Lord Vamanadeva came to help the demigods to get back the higher planets.
主巴曼的 Deva 来帮助半圣人来夺回高等的星球。
So the demigods, they are Sakama devotees.
半神人被称为 Sakama 的奉献者。
And Bali Maharaj, he's an Akama devotee. He had no material desire.
而 Bali Maharaj, 他被称为 Akama 奉献者，就是没有物质欲望。
So when the demigods get in trouble, because they have material desires, they have attachments, when they get in trouble, then they go to the Supreme Lord for help.
当半神人处在麻烦之中的时候，他们总是去找至尊人格守身本人寻求帮助。
But the pure devotees who don't have any material desire, they won't disturb the Lord. They won't go and ask him for their material benefit.
但是对于纯粹奉献者来说，即便他们处于麻烦危险之中，他们也不去为了个人的利益去打扰至尊主。
Yeah, if a devotee is suffering,He thinks this is due to his past activities that he did impious activities, so he's suffering.
对于一个纯粹奉献者来说，他如果在遭受痛苦的话，他认为这是他过去的不虔诚的活动而导致的恶报，他得承受这些活动的结果。
Yeah, he agrees to suffer the consequences.
他不为了这样的理由去他认为这是不虔诚的活动所致。
But he won't disturb the Lord. He's not going to go and run to the Lord that, oh, you have to protect me, help me.
但是他不会为了这个情况去打扰至尊主，说你得应该来帮我。
But devotees with material desires, they will pray to Krishna whenever they're in difficulty.
但是对于那些不纯粹的奉献者，他们总是一有麻烦他就想要去打扰至尊主。
But still, the people think that they'll say, no, these are pious devotees because they went to the Lord.
但即便是这样的 Sakama devotee, 他们仍然也被认为是虔诚的，因为他们在依靠着主。
So even when a devotee is suffering, a devotee will simply offer prayers to the Lord. Even when a devotee is suffering, they will just pray to the Lord. They won't pray to the Lord to save them, but they will just glorify the Lord. They will continue to glorify the Lord and to serve the Lord.
对于奉献者来说，即便他在遭受痛苦，他仍然向主祈祷，他仍然在荣耀着至尊主。
And they'll become more enthusiastic. The more they're in difficulty and hardships, the more enthusiastic they'll be to worship Krishna.
他们越是处在这种痛苦，他们越非常热情的、积极的去荣耀至尊。
So because they're fixed in devotional service, they can go back to Godhead.
因为他们专注于做奉献服务，所以他们能够回归家园，回归守身。
But the devotees who have material desires, they will get the result of their prayers.
那些有物质欲望的奉献者，他们会通过他们的祷文得到他们想要的结果。
But they don't immediately go back to Godhead.
但是他们不会立即的回归守神。
So Lord Vishnu, in his previous incarnations, he would always protect.He was always the proprietor of his devotees.
所以主 Vishnu 以他的各种化身恒常保护着他的奉献者。
So Krishna is the original personality of Godhead.
主 Krishna 是一切，是原初的那位至尊人格首身。
And all the other incarnations, they all come from him.
所有的化身都来自于他。
So the demigods continue praying, they pray to the Lord, O Supreme Protector, O Grandfather, O Supreme Pure.
半神人继续向至尊主祈祷道，哦，至尊的保护者，祖父啊，至高无上的纯粹啊。
They said, we are all surrendered souls at your lotus feet.
我们都是您莲花足下臣服的灵魂。
Our minds are tied to your lotus feet.
我们的心意捆绑在您的莲花足下。
We have chains of love tying our minds to your lotus feet.
我们的心意在冥想中的被爱的锁链捆绑在您的莲花足下。
So can please show us, we want to see your incarnation.
请您展示吧，我想看到您的这个化身。
Please accept us as your servants.
请接受我们作为您的仆人。
And we are your devotees.
我们是您的奉献者。
So be pleased with us.
请对我们满意。
And show your sympathy towards us.
请展示您的怜悯。
Just by your glance, by your loving glance, it's very, we feel cool and pleased.
只是您充满爱的瞥视，就让我们感到清凉和仁慈。
And the sweet words which come from your beautiful face, they free us from all the anxiety.
您美丽的话语从您美丽的面庞流露出，去除了我们所有的焦虑。
We're all in anxiety because of that big demon Vritasura.
我们之所以焦虑，就是因为那个恶魔 Vritasura.
It gives pain to our heart.
它总是让我们的内心痛苦。
So Lord Brahma is the father of the demigods.
主 Brahma 是半神人的父亲。
But Krishna is the father of Brahma.
但是主 Krishna 又是主 Brahma 的父亲。
Because Brahma was born from the lotus flower, which came from the navel of Lord Vishnu.
因为主 Brahma 诞生于主 Vishnu 的肚脐上的那个莲花之上。
The demigods continue. They say,Just like small sparks of a fire cannot have the same effect as a whole fire.
半神人继续祈祷道，就像一堆微小的火花不可能像整团火那么有效果。
So the demigods say, we're like little sparks of the Supreme Lord.
我们就像至尊主那些微小的火星一样。
So it's not possible for us to tell you what we need in our life.
我们不能告知您我们生活的需要。
You are the complete whole.
您是完整的整体。
So we don't need to tell you anything, you know everything.
因此我们不需要告诉您一切，您就知道一切。
You're the cause of the whole cosmic world.
您是一切的知悉者，您是宇宙的根源。
You're the maintainer and the annihilator of the material world.
您是物质宇宙的创造、维系和毁灭者。
You're always engaged in your pastimes.
您总是在从事着您的逍遥时光。
You have your spiritual and you have material energies.
您有各种灵性和物质的能量。
So you're the controller of all these energies.
您是所有这些能量的控制者。
And you live within all the living entities.
您处在所有的物质生物。
You live,
处在所有的生物体之内。
You live within the material world.
您存在于物质展示之内。
And you live beyond the world also.
也存在于物质展示之外。
Internally, you're the Parabrahman.
在内在您是 para brahman
and externally you're the ingredients of the material world
外在的您是物质创造元素
so you manifest at different stages and at different times and at different places and in different bodies
您展示在各种阶段各种时间各种的地点以及各种的躯体之中
You're the original cause of all causes.
您是一切原因的源头
You're the original element.
您是原初的元素
You're the witness of all activities.
您是所有活动的见证者
And you're as great as the sky.
您像天空一样伟大
And you are never touched.By any of them.
而且您从来不会被他们任何所触碰。
You're the witness of everything.
您是一切的见证者。
You're Parabrahman and you're Paramatma.
您是 Parabrahman, 您也是至尊凡，您也是超宁。
There's nothing unknown to you.
对于您来说，没有什么您不知道的。
Yeah, the absolute truth is there in three stages: is Brahman, Paramatma, and Bhagavan.
至尊绝对真理存在于三个阶段：至尊凡、超宁，哦不，就是 Brahman 凡、超宁、Paramatma 和 Bhagavan 至尊凡。
So Bhagavan is the cause of Brahman and Paramatma.
Bhagavan 是 Paramatma 和 Brahman 的源头。
Brahman is the impersonal absolute truth.
Brahman 凡是非人格对 真理。
So that is all pervading.
它是无所不在的。
And the Paramatma is in everybody's heart.
而 Paramatma 就是超宁。处在每一个人的心中。
But Bhagavan is worshipped by the devotees. He's the original cause of all causes.
而 Bhagavan 他被所有的奉献者所崇拜，他是一切的原因的原因。
So a pure devotee knows that nothing is unknown to the Lord.
一位纯粹的奉献者，他知道对于至尊。对于至尊主来说，没有什么是他不知道的。
So we don't have to tell the Lord about a devotee's difficulties or what's good or what's bad for a devotee. The Lord knows everything.
我们不必要跟至尊主说，到底什么好和什么不好。对于一个奉献者来说，什么是好，什么是不好，至尊主他是知道这一切的。
So pure devotee knows there's no need to tell Krishna anything.
一位纯粹奉献者来知道，他没有必要跟主告诉主一切。
You don't have to tell Krishna we need something. We don't have this. We don't have that. Krishna knows.
纯粹奉献者知道，他不必要告诉至尊主我需要这个，我需要那个。至尊主他是知道这一切。
So when the demigods were telling Lord Narayan about their distress, because they were being attacked by Vritasura.They actually had to apologize for offering prayers like that for their safety.
So, 半世人在向至尊主那样的供奉这个祷文，来表述他们被维彻苏惹所攻击的这个又处在悲伤情况之中这一情况的时候，事实上，半世人对至尊主有一点抱歉。他说这些事情，他感觉到有一点抱歉。
Because they're not supposed to ask for anything from the Lord.
他们不应该向至尊主去要求这些事情。
Neophyte devotees, they will do that. They will approach the Lord to help them in distress.
一位初级奉献者或许为了从痛苦或贫困之中解脱出来而去做这样的事情。
Maybe we've got some problem, no money, or maybe we're just.Trying to speculate knowledge about the Lord.
比如说，一个初级奉献者，他或许为了想要金钱，或许想为了 推敲至尊主的这些知识而接近主。
So these four kinds of people, they described in the Bhagavad Gita, that they all come to Krishna to surrender.
在《薄伽梵歌》中，在《薄伽梵歌》中提到了这四类人，他们接近主 Krishna.
Chaturvidha bhajante mam jnana sukritino Arjuna arto jignasur artarti jnani cha bharata shabha. Four kinds of pious people surrender to Krishna.
有四类人会臣服于主 Krishna.
Somebody is inquisitive, somebody is in search of wealth, somebody is in distress, and somebody is in search of knowledge.
痛苦的人，需要钱的人，追求财富的人，就是好奇的人和追求绝对真理的人。
But the pure devotee knows that Krishna is everywhere and he knows everything, so you don't have to tell him.
然而一位纯粹奉献者他知道主是无所不在无所不知的，所以没有必要跟主去讲这些自己所需要的事情。
So we don't offer prayers or worship Krishna for our protection.
所以我们不像至尊主供奉祷文来寻求自我的保护。
We don't have to ask for our personal benefit.
我们不向主要求我们个人的利益。
A pure devotee will just do service without asking anything.
一位纯粹奉献者只是做服务而不要求任何别的事情。
Krishna knows what we need.
主 Krishna 知道我们到底需要什么。
So we shouldn't disturb Krishna by asking him for material benefits.
我们不要为了个人的物质利益而去打扰主 Krishna.
Okay, so we will stop here.
Okay, 我们现在讲到这里。
So are there any questions?
Yes, first question from Yovati Vishaka.顶拜咕噜的莲花族顶拜翻译，请问咕噜，什么样的奉献者能回归家园？什么样的奉献者不能回归家园？感恩。Obeisance to Guru's lotus feet, I want to ask Guru, what kind of devotees can go back to Godhead, and what kind of devotees cannot back to Godhead? Thank you.
Well, the devotees go back to Godhead are the ones who want to love Krishna and be with Krishna.
能回归家园、回归守神的奉献者，他一定是想和 Krishna 在一起、爱 Krishna 的人。
And those devotees who don't go back to Godhead, they're the ones with the material desires.
而那些不能够回归家园的奉献者，一定是有物质欲望。
They want to enjoy the material world.
他们还想在物质世界享受。
They're very attached to the family.
他们非常依附于他们的家庭。
They don't want to leave the children, the grandchildren. They don't want to leave the home. They're so attached.
他们不想离开他们的孩子、孙子，他们也不想离开他们的家。
So we have to understand, we came here with nothing, we'll leave with nothing.
我们要了解的是，我们来到这里是一无所有的，我们离开的时候也是一无所有的。
So we are thinking, my family,It's not really my family. We had many families in the past.
我们要知道，我们现在的这个家庭，事实上也不是我们的家庭。我们是在过去，其实也有很多的，有很多的家庭。
So we have to get free from this material attachment to go back to Godhead.
要回归守神，我们要从这些物质的依附之中解脱出来。
We have to really want to love Krishna.
我们要真正的想要去爱 Krishna.
Our real family is there with Krishna.
我们真正的家庭在那里，是和 Krishna 在一起的那个家。
Okay.
好。下一个问题来自于 Vedavati Madhaji. Hare Krishna, 顶拜 Guru, 感恩翻译。请问怎样从物质三属性之中感受到至尊主的存在？Hare Krishna, basis to Guru. I want to know how to feel the Lord himself from the material three modes.
How to, I'm sorry, how to what?
How to know Krishna, how to the Lord himself, and from the three modes of the nature.
What about the three modes of nature?
Because in the today's purport also said the devotee, he knows the Lord in the three modes of the nature.
He knows the Lord in three modes of nature. Well, creation is the work of passion, maintenance is the work of goodness, and destruction is the work of ignorance.
维系是来自于善良形态，创造是来自于畸形形态，而毁灭是来自于愚昧形态。
The material nature, the material energy, three modes, that's under the control of Krishna.
物质自然三属性是在至尊主 Krishna 的控制之下。
In the Bhagavad Gita, Krishna says, material nature moves under his control.
在《薄伽梵歌》中，主 Krishna 说，物质自然三形态，物质自然在他的控制之下。
It's not independent.
它不是独立的。
So in the Brahma Samhita, it says that the material nature is controlled by Mother Durga.
在 Brahma Samhita 中说，物质自然是在物质自然三形态是在母亲 Durga 女神的控制之下。
But Mother Durga, she's under the control of Krishna.
但是母亲 Durga 却在主 Krishna 的控制之下。
She moves like a shadow under the control of Lord Krishna.
她就像主 Krishna 的一个影子。
Okay.
Next question from the Hari Priya, David Dasi. 顶拜孤的莲花族顶拜翻译，请问孤乳怎样处理香的外包装灵性笔记本？A basis to Guru's Lord's feet. How to deal with the out package of the incense and notebooks? Because some incense is box is with some Hare Krishna mantra or Krishna's picture. I think her question is like this: how to deal with these things?
Well, you can bury them in the ground, or you can put them in the sea.
你可以把它们埋在土底下，或者把它们扔到海里面去。
Or you can cut them out and put them on your wall, stick them on your wall.
或者你可以把它们剪下来，然后粘贴到你的门上，你的墙上。Next question.
Yeah.
Next question from I think is Sati Manchi.顶拜孤儿的莲花族，顶拜聚会的奉献者，请问孤儿马哈拉吉，作为门徒是不是也应该认识到，孤儿作为超灵的代表，他也了解门徒的一切，门徒不应该告诉孤儿应该做这个，应该做那个，也不应该去打扰孤儿，向他要求物质的祝福等等。A basis to Guru's Lord's feet, I want to ask Guru Maharaj, as a disciple of the spiritual mother, whether the disciple should ask, the disciple should know the guru is the representative of the super soul. So the guru should know the everything of the disciple. Then the disciple should not tell the guru.What he should do this, what he should not do that, and also not disturb the guru. He wants some material blessings.
Yes, it's not proper for the disciple to give instruction to the guru.
是的，门徒向孤儒给予门徒给予孤儒训示，这个是不好的。
The instruction can come from the peers, not shouldn't come from the disciples.
Peers
means people of the same position.
Oh, okay. 这个训示应该是来自于同等地位的，比如说孤儒的这些同伴，或者说同等地位的这些。
Yeah. God brothers.
但是而不应该来自于他的门徒，比如说孤儒的。孤儒的神性兄弟可以给他训示，但是孤儒的门徒不应该给予孤儒训示。
那 disciple has some problem, some distress. He may ask come to the guru for blessings. Well, we should ask for the blessing in a spiritual way, not material way. You can get spiritual blessings. You shouldn't come for material blessings.
至于门徒。要向孤儒寻求这些物质上的祝福。关于这一点，门徒可以以一种灵性的方式去寻求灵性的祝福，而不要这种物质上的祝福或利益。
Just like somebody has some disease, okay, so we should pray, you know, may you always be in Krishna consciousness.Whatever happens, may you always remember Krishna.
比如说，有人有一些物质身体上的疾病，我们可以祝福他，愿你永远无论在任何样的情况下都能具有 Krishna 知觉。
There's one devotee, very nice devotee, who was in Mayapur often, big tall American devotee, proper disciple.So he just always liked to take the ghee lamp around at Mangal Arati in the morning in the temple in Mayapur when the temple was packed with so many people. He would walk around, take the ghee lamp around everybody.
在 Mayapur 有一个非常好的一位奉献者圣帕帕的门徒，他是一个美国人，然后他经常在 Mangal Arati 的时候把这个灯给予每一个人，就是点完灯的那供奉完的那个灯给每一个人。
So recently they announced he's diagnosed with cancer at the fourth stage.
最近的一个诊断表明他现在处于癌症的第四阶段。
So he put a notice on Facebook. He said, "You don't have to pray for me to."Get cured or anything. He said, just pray to whatever happens that I will always be in Krishna consciousness.
So he has a Facebook 公开的告示说，请大家不要祈祷着说，为主祈祷着说，希望我能够康复。请大家祈祷，向主祈祷，愿我无论在任何处境下，愿我能够有 Krishna 知觉。
And pray that I can accept whatever Krishna has arranged for me.
请祈祷着我无论在任何情况下都能接受主 Krishna 对我的安排。
So that is Krishna consciousness.
所以这是一种 Krishna 知觉。
Okay, 下一个问题。
好，下一个问题来自于 Vaishnava Vani Madhaji. Hare Krishna Guru Maharaj, my humble basis. Lord Krishna is above the happiness and the distress.I was thinking if the Supreme Lord has one unhappiness that there are so many conditioned souls suffering, is that correct? Hare Krishna Guru Maharaj, 我卑微的顶拜，主 Krishna 是超越于快乐和痛苦的。我在想，是否至尊主有一个不快乐，那么就会有成千就会有很多这些受条件限制的灵魂就会痛苦，这样理解是对吗？ Hare Krishna.
Yes, Krishna has many conditioned souls.
是主 Krishna 有很多 受条件限制的灵魂。
But there's many more souls who are liberated than conditioned.
但是也有很多，解脱了的灵魂，而不是受条件限制的灵魂。
The spiritual world is much bigger than the material world.
灵性世界要比物质世界大很多的倍。
So there's many, many more souls in the spiritual world than what's in the material world.
在灵性世界有很多很多的灵魂，那些远超过我们物质存在的这些灵魂。
But still, Krishna thinks about delivering the conditioned souls.
但是主 Krishna 仍然在想着把这些受条件限制的灵魂帮助他们解脱。
He feels compassion on them.
他感觉到。对他们非常的怜悯。
Just like a government has a prison house, and they have people in the jail, and they think how to reform them.
就像政府也有监狱，但是他们也在想着如何让这些人从监狱中走出来。
Okay.
Okay. Next question from 珍珍。Hare Krishna, 顶拜 Guru Maharaj 的甜美莲花组，顶拜所有奉献者，一切荣耀归于世人帕帕。请问 Guru, 新奉献者向 Krishna 祈祷做好工作的服务，祈祷家庭的服务，祈祷家庭的服务，是不是把所有这些活动变成奉献服务，渐渐的就能朝着变得纯粹的方向走呢？就能变得越来越进步呢？感恩 Guru。Hare Krishna,obeisances to Guru Maharaj's lotus feet. And I want to ask Guru, the neophyte devotees ask, 向 Krishna 祈祷, ask the Lord Krishna and pray for can do better work. 祈祷做好工作的, pray for the Lord, he can do the better work. And better,祈祷 and pray the family this kind of service. If this means change the, all these kind of activities to the devotional service, then I can become more and more pure and more advanced.
Yes, very good.
是的，很好。
If you can become more and more pure,more and more advanced.
如果你能变得越来越纯粹，越来越进步。
But mostly we find that when people do more, when you do better in your job, you become more and more materialistic.
但是通常情况下，如果想越来越好的工作的话，它是会变得越来越物质的。
You think I'm a very great worker, I'm very good in business, I'm doing very nice work.
哦，你会认为我现在的工作做得这么好，我现在是一个非常好的一个工作者，我做了很好的这个生意等等这样的一些工作，我做得很好。
And we become forgetful about Krishna.
然后你就会忘了 Krishna.
And we start to think I am the center of the universe.
然后你就会想着我是整个宇宙的中心。
I am very great worker, very great, very great woman.That have wonderful qualities.
我做着，我是一个非常好的一个工作者，我是一个，我有着非常好的品质，我是整个宇宙的中心。
So you have to be very careful.
因此你也得非常小心。
Because it's very easy to forget Krishna.
因为忘记 Krishna 是非常容易的。
So Krishna knows what's good for us.
主 Krishna 知道对于我们到底什么是好。
So you don't have to pray to him to give you blessings.
你不必要向他祈祷，请给我祝福。
You just pray to him that I can always remember your lotus feet.
你只是向他祈祷，愿我自己能够永远记着您的莲花足。
Okay.
好，我们。下一个问题来自于 Radhe Shyam, 顶拜 Guru 和翻译，顶拜奉献者。请问 Krishna 处在所有生物体的心中，知道我们所有的欲望，那我们还能向主 Krishna 祈祷什么呢？ Obeisances to Guru and all devotees, I want to ask if the Krishna in everyone's heart and knows everyone's desire. So, what should we pray to the Lord Krishna?
We should pray, please engage me in your service.
我们向 Krishna 祈祷，请让我们从事对您的奉献服务。
That's our only prayer. Please engage me in your service.
这是唯一的祈祷，请让我们从事对您的奉献。
That's why we constantly chant Hare Krishna mantra.
这就是为什么我们要一直不断地唱诵 Hare Krishna mantra.
Hare Krishna mantra means, please engage me in your service.
Hare Krishna mantra 是的意思是，请让我从事对您的奉献。Hare Priya David Dasi 又接着问，请问怎么样处理大量听课笔记和草稿纸？How to deal with a lot of that notes of the spiritual lectures? We listen the lectures and we take a lot of note. How to deal with many of these notes, these papers,
notebooks? Well.You can bury them. You can put them in the fire. When we do a fire sacrifice, when there's a fire yagna, you can put them in the fire and burn it.
你也可以埋了它，你也可以在比如说我们做祭祀的时候，你可以把它点了，把它烧了。Okay. Next question from Tejas Prabhu. Hare Krishna, 顶拜灵性导师和奉献者。每天我都会向主尼星哈祈祷，保佑我们的奉献者，包括我们自身的传教顺利等等，这些会不会打扰到主，觉得我们好烦 ？Hare Krishna, obeisance to spiritual master, Guru Maharaj. Every day I will pray to the Lord Nishinha Dev, include protect our devotees and our preaching work.Wish our preaching very nice, successful. So these kind of prayers, whether will disturb the Lord, and the Lord will fail us very boring.
Well, Lord Nrisimhadev knows what his duty is.
主Nrisimhadev 知道他的责任是什么。
So you should just worship Lord Nrisimhadev.
所以你只需要去崇拜主Nrisimhadev。
Chant the Nrisimha mantra.
唱诵李生哈的那个曼陀罗。
Just like we sing Nrisimha prayers every day. So you sing that.
就像我们每天唱诵的主李生哈的那个供奉祷文。
So that will protect all the devotees.
这就能保护所有的奉献者。
You don't have to tell Lord Nrisimhadev what to do.
你不必要告诉主李生哈 Dev 到底该做什么。
You just have to worship him nicely.
你只需要很好的去崇拜他。Next question from Sri Devi Gaurangi Devi Dasi. Hare Krishna, Guru Maharaj, please accept my humble basis or glory to Srila Prabhupada. How do we distinguish between Lord Krishna arrangement and our own karmic reactions?Or actions of the weak the material unto us. Hare Krishna, Guru Maharaj, 请接受我卑微顶拜一切如来归身帕帕。如何区别主 Krishna 的愿安排和就是如何区别主到底是主 Krishna 的安排呢？还是我们自身的业报反应或者这些物质的活动的这个对于我们的反应呢？
Well, karmic reactions is also the arrangement that's authorized by Krishna.
业物质的业报反应也是主 Krishna 的安排。
Krishna authorizes that this person is under the material energy, is not serving me, so let him enjoy his karma or suffer his karma.
这个业报反应是主 Krishna 自动安排这个系统， 当有奉献者说哦，你现在不想臣服于我，那么就让你去承受你的业报的反应吧。
嗯。So, if we have actually surrendered to Krishna, then Krishna is not going to give, we're not going to suffer karma.
如果我们能够真实的臣服于主 Krishna 的话，我们不会完全的遭受业报的反应。
But a devotee always thinks whatever sufferings he gets, that is the arrangement of his karma.
但是一个奉献者，他会想，无论他他遭受了什么样的痛苦，这些都是他由于他过去的这些 karma 所致。
Devotee is humble. He doesn't. He never thinks I've surrendered to Krishna. He's always trying to surrender to Krishna.
奉献者总是很谦卑的，他总是不会认为说自己是臣服了 Krishna. 他总是在想着我要尝试着努力的去臣服 Krishna.
We're always trying to come closer to surrender to Krishna.
我们在试着更接近更。进一步的臣服主 Krishna.
Yeah.
Okay. Next question from Gati Prada. 顶拜 Gurudev 和所有的奉献者，物质的焦虑，对主 Krishna 没有信心和奉爱的，物质的焦虑是对主 Krishna 没有信心和奉爱的表现吗？如果在生意上遇到挫败，可以理解这是主 Krishna 对我的考验，是对我灵性生活的最好安排吗？Obeisances to Guru and all devotees. The material anxiety, it means I have no faith and devotional to the Lord Krishna.
Well, it means your faith may be weak.
物质的焦虑意味着你的信心是很虚弱的。
Means you're not yet a pure devotee.
意味着你现在不是一个纯粹的奉献者。If I have a distress in the business, I'm failed in the business, is that, can I understand that this is the test that Lord Krishna gave to me? Or, and also this is the very good spiritual arrangement by the Lord Krishna?
Yes, we should think like that.
我们可以这样，我们应该这样去理解。
Think this is a special test from Krishna.
这是主 Krishna 对我的考验。Next question.
Yeah.
Next question from Yuna. Hare Krishna, Guru Maharaj, and dear devotees, please accept my humble obeisances. All glory to Srila Prabhupada. If I remember Krishna.Is it the same when I think I am not a body? Hare Krishna, Guru Maharaj, 亲爱的奉献者，请接受卑微的顶拜，一千荣耀归帕帕。如果我想着 Krishna, 这是不是与此同时，我在那个时候想着我不是这个躯体？
When I think I'm not the body, then I think I'm Krishna.
If I remember Krishna, is it the same when I think I'm not the body?
No, not exactly.
不确切是这样的。
If you remember Krishna, the question is how you remember Krishna and how you think of Krishna.
你在想着 Krishna, 这个问题是，问题是你是怎么样想着 Krishna?
Some people think of Krishna as an ordinary person.
有一些人想 Krishna 是想着他是一个普通人。
Some people think, oh, Krishna took birth and Krishna died.
有一些人认为 Krishna 既出生也死亡。
So how do you think of Krishna?
所以要看一看你是怎么想着 Krishna。
It's not just because I'm thinking of Krishna.
这不仅仅是说哦，我现在是想着 Krishna。
So I know I'm not the body。
所以我就能认为我现在就不是我这个躯体。
Not necessary, may not be like that.
或许不是这样的。
How do you think of Krishna? You're thinking of Krishna, but how do you think of Krishna? Do you think of Krishna as the Supreme Personality of Godhead? Do you think of him as unborn, as having a transcendental body?
你是怎么想着 Krishna 呢？你是认为 Krishna 是至尊人格守神吗？还是说你认为 Krishna 是不经出生而且没有物质的躯体呢？
So I'm not the body. You're not the body either. You're detached from the body. That's very nice. But are you attached to Krishna?
我不是这个躯体，这非常好，表明你不依附于这个物质躯体。但是你是否依附 Krishna 呢？
Some people, they give up the attachment to the body. But they're not,
有一些人能够放弃对物质躯体的依附。
They're not attached to Krishna.
但是他们也不依附主 Krishna.
Recording stopped.
Really?
Hare Krishna Gurudev. The question finished.
Question finished? Okay.
Yes.
So okay. We'll stop here tonight?
好，我们今天讲到这儿。
Om Vichangan Shisubudi Rai Prabhu Gewaman Gentai Defani Om Ganshi Sati Jujur Ganshi Sauda Funkshensa Ling Ting Timan Om Juhu Niman Shangha Kwaila Wanshit Rui Twanjao Shunli Damodar Yu Kwaila Hare Krishna
Hare Krishna
Hare Krishna
Srila Prabhupada Ki
Jaya